Hello everyone, very good morning to all who are watching me on First Cry in Delhi. I'm so glad to be here. I, Dr. Megha Bhatt, founder Sinotech, a platform for science communication for school children, and I'm here to talk and help parents to develop creative and scientific thinking in children. Now, for that, I think I should begin with something which is scientific aptitude and attitude, which I would be talking to you about, and it all starts with inborn creativity. Now, first of all, let me introduce myself. I'm founder Sinotech, as I said, and it's a platform for science communication. Basically, we have different work modules in terms of year-long program, which we run in the academy at city of Ahmedabad, Gujarat. And then I do lots of workshop across the globe now. And we are also running online. So we are on to virtual platform. And I do lots of teachers training programs to propagate the idea of science communication. So my dear friends, let me begin for today's program. First of all, as I said, if we talk about creativity, people really think that it is inborn. But in my opinion, that is just not correct. It can be surely developed and eventually nurtured by parents, caretakers, in the face of grandparents, whoever is spending time with the child, and of course, a very crucial role being played by teachers. Actually, we say that creativity is more about the skill-based learning rather than an inborn ability. So, and trust me, parents, kids' perception is often way more creative than what we think. And in fact, they might just come up with some ideas which are so innovative that we would not even think about in wildest of our dreams, I guess. So in Sinotech, which is combination of, as I said, science for science, sci of science, no of knowledge, and tech of technology. We believe in exposure leads to exploration and exploration to innovation. But where will this innovation come from, my friends? In every business or any activity, everyone wants something which is little hutke, or what's that little hutke or X factor we are talking about? We are talking about, it's all about the creativity of your brand, which makes you different from your competitors. So since creativity is the key to success in nearly everything we do, it becomes really crucial to impart knowledge about critical thinking in kids from their very young age, especially in their formative years. And mind you, it's not limited to art, music, and dance. It is must for science in terms of scientific aptitude and attitude, as I said earlier, subject of mathematics, linguistic, naturalist, bodily kinesthetic, whatever child is interested in, and even social and emotional intelligence. So creative minds are supposedly more flexible, and given situation, they emerge out as better problem solvers, my friends. And this problem solving ability make them more capable in terms of adapting to any given situation and will be able to grab any opportunity coming in their way at the right time. And that is what is something very, very important, and which probably in future, which will make their startups as a differentiator in the market. So since First Cry is all about the little ones, and let me focus more on that age group today. So till 5 years, their world is all imagination and magic. So let it remain that way. Let them have a gift placed in a sock under their cushion on a Christmas night. And that's what I used to do to my child. And let them imagine how Santa got a gift, what he or she wished for. And trust me, up to 6 years, my child never realized. But once he actually asked me that in this particular weather, how can a Santa come in a sledge when there is no snow? So imagine that he started thinking on that line, that we being in the arid area or a dry area, how can a Santa drive his sledge? So my dear friends, try doing something which is little different, and where, you know, child has a scope of imagining things in his own way and coming to you with lots of innovative questions. So the scientific data says that for many children, their creativity will reach its peak before the age of 6, after which it will begin to decline with the onset of formal schooling. And then, naturally, in accordance with the developmental environment which is being provided to the child. Okay. So, however, supporting your child's creativity at very young age, that is 3 to 5 years, sets the perfect stage to enrich its continued development in the years beyond. So, here are I'm just going to give some 12 easy ways to help children in expressing their creativity. So let's start with the first one. And possibly this is in all my talks, I always, even if I have just 5 minutes to talk, I always give them this idea that out of this 12, there are 5 very essential things which we must do for at least nurturing scientific ability, all right, and also creativity. So help children to observe things around. That is number one. Help children to observe things around. Help them to observe. Prompt them to observe which is not easily seen by everyone. Now, suppose if you're standing next to a tree, tell them to observe. And children will start telling you that, or a child will start telling you that, okay, there are leaves of this size, shape, maybe they are, you know, facing down so that to get more of sunlight, and many, many things they will start telling you, probably about the trunk. The idea that, okay, because it's a tree, there is a trunk, there are branches and all that. Now, try prompting, okay, that, okay, if you are able to see the trunk, what kind of trunk it is? Is it having any pattern in terms of having a distinguished bark for a specific tree, which makes that tree different from others? Does it have any pattern? Is there a, suppose, observe up aerially over the trunk and ask them that, okay, if they are able to see something, if there is a nest there or a specific bird sitting on that specific tree only. And see, the idea is that the observational abilities, if they improvise, then probably, you know, they are able to think beyond what they are able to see or what they have been told. Because see, I gave you a very simple example, but in future, if they become naturalists, they will observe that certain birds always choose certain trees to sit on. All right. So it's not like birds also have habitats like us, and that is what makes them unique to that particular species. So suppose, second example, say if we are standing next to the beach, tell them to observe everything. They will tell you about the water and the waves and the color of the water. At that very point of time, they may not realize that the color of the water is different because they feel that everything is blue, all right? But probably when you go to different places and try telling them to compare the color of the water or the things around, whether there are mountains, where there is greenery, or probably only water around. So probably the sand color. Okay, now sand color is always different. The texture of the sand is also different everywhere you go. So try telling them to feel, touch and feel everything. And for the toddlers, you know, that will help tremendously. And trust me, before I wind up my first suggestion that help children to observe things, my very first request to parents is that if at all he or she, the child, is not able to observe as much as you can at that very point of time, then please do not shout at them. All right. Slowly and steadily, you know, they will start observing, and that is a gradual process. Please understand. All right. So make them better observers and also good listeners. Ask them to listen. All right. And if they are, and naturally, if the teacher is good, they will make them participate as much as possible. But at the same time, instead of just showing what they know, probably sometimes if they are listening, that also makes a lot of sense. Then my second clue is make children question things. So my friends, make children question things. So one of the main ways of developing creative thinking in children is to urge them to wonder. Whenever you are spending time with them, ask them lots of questions. What kind of questions you could ask? Something very different. Okay. Say the common question is, why is the sky blue? Okay, but instead of that, probably you can also say that, okay, let's try observing for a week, let's try observing the color of the sky every day, beta. Okay, and every day, can we see the same amount of clouds? Okay, is the cloud color different every day? All right, are there shades of blue, or are there shades of gray, or grayish black? What is the difference? Okay, and why there is a difference? And everything has a reason. So naturally, you will be able to answer all those questions. If you are not able to answer, Google Maharaj or any other browser is there to answer all your questions. The point is here that child should be able to ask questions. Okay, so to prompt that and to help your child asking questions, you must ask them certain questions which will prompt them to think. So how are we able to stand if the earth is a globe? All right, in my family, they are little children. So basically both of them, the twin, they are five, and they keep on asking me, all right, that if earth is a globe, all right, and if that is the case, how are we able to stand? Why are we not falling down? So see how beautiful an idea by a age five child. So how does the gravity work and all that, we can always explain later, but probably it's a beautiful idea if they are asking something, right? So explaining such them to them would help them in becoming really curious and thereby enhancing their imaginative skills and inculcating problem solving abilities, as I said earlier. So let me show my first experiment for today, where I try generating curiosity in you, all right, my dear parents, by asking a simple question, all right, that suppose this particular experiment which I'm talking to you about is chromatography. For multiple reasons I'm showing you this particular experiment, because my simple question is that suppose if I have two different sketch pens, all right, I have two different sketch pens, black sketch pen, there is a black sketch pen and there is a black marker, and I have a piece of paper. I have a piece of paper now over which, in front of you only, I will make up a dot. So my first dot is over, all right, and a same size dot, let me put it with this marker pen in front of you. So both the dots are almost of the same size, all right, and my question is that will this show different colors if at all they are being put up in water? That is the first question. Okay, now as adults also, we would be wondering that if I am having a whiteboard marker and if I have a simple sketch pen, will it show a same pattern if I put it in water? So I can say, my dear children or my dear parents, do we know the answer? So let us check out. So we have to wait for the experiment to get over to see the result. But for this, let me put it, okay? I have a jar of water, and for which probably I'll be able to show it to you properly, that if at all, what I have to do is that I have to exactly measure the length of my strip, all right, and turn it there. And what I'm going to do is that to make it stand straight, I will be putting up on the ruler, okay, so that it just sits properly. With a cello tape, I will try putting it up. And in front of you only, I'll be doing this. So let it be and let us observe, all right. So now you all are able to see that my strip is touching water, all right. So let me keep it aside, my friends, all right. And once I keep it aside, trust me that let us await for the good results, all right. Let me keep it aside, this particular experiment, and as soon as the result starts getting in, I will show it to you, the strip, after taking it out. All right, so that was about the first experiment. And you will be amazed that just the question what we asked, that okay, will the black color being the black color in the sketch pen same as a whiteboard marker, the black color? Okay, so let us check out. So third, so that was the second one. So generate, try generating questions, ask lots of questions. Third, provide ample of opportunities, okay, to express their intelligence. Now, science actually, in the idea is that there are different types of intelligences. And now we do not know that it does not, see, it is not necessarily something which is hereditary. But at the same time, something which child could be interested in and having a different kind of intelligence inbuilt. All right. So another important thing is to remember that even though there are different types of intelligences, they can be developed over time. Even the child isn't necessarily exhibiting the characteristics. Sometimes it is difficult to recognize their natural inclination towards certain form of intelligence. In that case, give them ample opportunities to express all the forms of intelligence and pick up on what they do the best. So, as I said earlier, the tagline of Sinotech is exposure leads to exploration. So, my dear friends, expose them to everything what comes up to the city. Okay, even if they are little, take them for a music concert, take them for a dance recital or arangetram, or sometimes for a hip-hop dancing. If somebody is doing, then for yoga, exercise, at least once. All right. I'm not telling you to do multiple activities at a time with the child. Okay. I'll be coming to that point also later. But at least once try exposing them to all the activities. And try looking at the child's interest and pursue only one or two. Now, I personally believe in that rather than becoming jack of all, it's always better to be master of one. Now, here I would like to give my very own child's example. Since he still is going to a beautiful school in Ahmedabad, one of the teachers, from the psychological perspective, in pre-K, she had advised that child being hyperactive, make him do some activities which are, which will divert his attention or divert his behavior in such a way that he will, constructively start doing some activities. So in that case, she had at that point of time suggested that you can pursue music or you can pursue swimming or cycling or something which will, take out his energies. And trust me, he used to enjoy everything, every bit what I did with him. But at the same time, as a mother, I can say that he distinctly showed the inclination towards music. Okay, he was very good with swimming also at that point of time, but for music I really thought that, oh my god, once something is being if you make him listen to something, he was he already started playing in terms of, and my husband used to keep engaging him in lots of other activities, like making him listen to different genres of music at that point of time. So basically, and right now I'm very happy to see that he's a pianist. So my dear friends, provide ample of opportunities for yourself to find out the inbuilt intelligence, what is already there, or inclination already there in your child, to identify that. Okay, now that was the third one. Then coming to the fourth one, engage them with age appropriate activities. Do not overexpose. All right, now this is something, a real problem these days. Creative intelligence and its importance depend on, as we said, that going beyond thinking, or what you call it, to be out of the box thinking for obvious things we are often presented with. To make it happen, they need some peaceful time away from digital gadgets, which is a little tough these days. I can understand that. So you can make your child think out of the box, engaging with creative games and activities. Again, I will give you my very own example. I used to make Rushin, sit up with jigsaw puzzles. When he was too little, I started with just two or four pieces, and trust me, at 5 years he was doing almost around 208 to 300 pieces puzzle. So and he was actually interested in that, and he had those abilities, but still, providing him at the right time with the right kind of puzzles, with two, four. See, if I would have exposed him with suddenly with 10 pieces or suddenly with 50 pieces at 2 years of age, then naturally he would not be interested, because 50 pieces he will not be able to do. Process is gradual. It is same like us in children also. Naturally, we don't learn something just like that, right? So the play-based learning tools help in developing various skills like coordination, self-expression, fine motor skills, and so promote that. So in Sinotech, I would again, one more example before showing one more experiment. I think I would give you this example that Sinotech, for example, is an experiential learning platform. Now, if at all I talk about the periphery of 2 kilometers, there must be around 15 plus activity centers who are doing science related or DIY kids related activities, irrespective of considering their age group. So, and at least whether it is proven or not, at least I believe that it has to be age appropriate. It has to be graded. The child could be, one or two grades here and there mentally, but at the same time, their interest and also in their aptitudes, they are different. I agree. But at the same time, probably parents are happy, that they are actively engaging their kids. But do they ever wonder whether is it meaningful, to enroll in such programs? Now, let me show you one simple idea. All right. Now, for this, I think, all right. So, I hope all of you are able to see the Gradle. All right. So, probably, let me put it a little down. So, this is Newton's Gradle. Okay. A perfect tool to demonstrate the Newton's third law, okay, action and reaction. Now, if I tell you that if I talk about this particular idea, it will be very enjoyable by a grade 2 child also, okay. Suppose if I start and give force of one particular ball, probably I hope you are all able to see. All right. So the idea would be really, really very, very enjoyable. Grade 2 child shown grade 6 concepts, it'll be resulting in grade 2 child, if they are overfed like this, they will not understand. They will not understand the core idea. And when they are in grade 6, they will lose out interest, as they will feel that I already know it, so they will lose out with the interest at all. So let me, put it this way, that once you are able to see this particular cradle and the balls, look at the balls carefully, okay? The idea is that if at all I put it this way, okay, if I start with putting a force, for one ball, the other side also the transformation of energy would be same. Alright, now if on the other side also, if I try putting it from the other side, you will notice that only one will move. Now, because the motion, the laws of motion, this is the perfect instrument to describe the laws of motion. But trust me, my dear friends, the child at grade 2 level will never understand action and reaction. Never ever. Okay, so basically, introducing force to something which is, so now suppose grade 6 child. Now for a grade 6 child, the explanation would be, now suppose if I tell you that if I move 2 balls from one side, you will notice that only 2 will move. Alright, and similar to that, if you insert the same kind of force from both the sides, look what happens. It naturally nullifies, and a grade 6 child also will be able to visualize, what I'm trying to tell them. So, my dear friends, what happens is that for a grade 2 child, it is very, very difficult for them to understand and demonstrate the idea of Newton's laws of motion, rather than, you know, I myself play tug of war with children when I'm introducing force or push or a pull. Simple, you know, that what is the size and what is the size of the force, what is the direction of the force, how the direction will be decided by somebody who is, you know, the side where there are more children in tug of war, naturally the direction will be decided by that group, right? So that is the whole idea, that do not overexpose children. Now, fifth one, ignite the inbuilt curiosity. My friends, children are born curious. They want to know extra about anything and everything. It is thus the responsibility of the parents and the teachers to provide interesting and relevant indications to further drive their curiosity towards the right direction. Let me show it with one more demonstration. Now, suppose if I correctly tell you that look at this particular pencil. Okay, now if I tell you that this particular pencil, you can see that I have drawn a black ring over there. Okay, that is the center of the pencil. Now, if I ask a simple question that will I be able to balance this pencil? All right, then please check it out. Naturally, as you know, and you ask children to observe, that naturally it is moving on my right and your left side. All right, but see, why is it happening like that? Because the child himself will be able to say, because there is a weight on this side, all right? Because there is a weight of an eraser. Now, how do I balance it? Okay, how do I balance it? So the whole idea that, okay, if at all in front of you only I'm doing, so you will be able to understand better probably. And if I tell you that I just put up a balloon on one side, only a little, see, if balloon is not available, it could be, the child himself or herself can think about alternative materials, okay? Your hair clip or probably some kind of weight which you can put up on the other side. Now, if I tell you that if there is an eraser on one side and I have put up a balloon on the other side, you can see that now I'm able to hold it stand straight. All right. So basically what I'm trying to tell you is that balancing is an idea where, you know, they must come up with a solution themselves. It's a kind of problem solving for them, that if the weight on the left hand side is same as the weight on the right hand side, naturally what happens is that idea is then only it will get balanced. Now, for this, probably I will ask parents one single question, that if I have a pencil, okay, if I have a pencil, and if I want to hold a pencil from one end, will I be able to do that? Yes, I will be able to do that. Okay, and for which, suppose this is a very simple thing what I have prepared. All right, now if I tell you that if I try holding it like this from one end also, not only from the center, let me hold it from one by one finger, and even the child with its little finger will be able to do that. Okay, now why is it possible? Because there is a weight which I have been putting up in such a way that you will be able to see that, just check out, the weight on the left hand side is so much, which is a buckle, all right, and you will be able to see that the weight on the right hand side is the pencil and the wire. So the buckle itself is, you know, so heavy that it actually neutralizes the weight of pencil and the wire, right? So one by one, see, basically you can say that now, see, the whole idea since beginning, you know, the whole idea that after 5 years, you should be able to, you know, after 5 years, okay, you should be able to know that whether, you know, the child is able to ask the correct kind of question. Now, let me, after this demonstration, probably, you know, I should be able to give you one very beautiful example. Now, have you ever seen on roadside a girl walking on a rope? All right. Now, when the girl walks on a rope, there is a loud music, all right, and usually being played, and ask the child to observe. Okay, ask the child to observe the scenario. There are lots of people standing next to that particular idea. The poor girl, she's walking on the rope very carefully. Observe that, ask child that, okay, is he or she able to observe everything? And the wait for correct kind of questions. If the correct kind of questions are not coming, then you can prompt, okay? You can prompt from your side that how is she balancing? Okay, how is she trying to balance herself? Why there is a loud music? Is music, has music to play any kind of role in the girl walking? Really, it is just to, invite the crowd. And why is she holding a stick in her hand while walking on a rope? What is the idea? So the whole idea is the same thing, my dear friends. We say that basically you will feel that, why am I telling you? But with this simple experiment, the principle remains the same, that she is every time trying to balance on the rope, that so you will notice that so you can also talk about deteriorating environmental situations with them and how it can affect the life of human beings and animals around. By involving them in such meaningful discussions, my friends, parents can get their curiosity going in a way that they would want to know more. Now, sixth one, different roads leading to same destination, that is multiple ways to solve every problem. As a parent or guardian, my dear friends, you must make your children understand that there are multiple ways to solve a problem and also different perspectives to look at everything. May it be a math problem or an emotional problem to deal with, they may face in a real life in future also. So there are multiple ways to solve every problem, as Einstein says it correctly, with a beautiful examples. You know, I usually in my larger workshops for teachers, I normally mention this particular example, that there are multiple solutions to every problem. I'll give you one simple example which I had read somewhere for preschoolers. So if you are asking a child, okay, preschooler, that do you want more blocks? If you have three blocks, I'll give you two more. How many will you have? All right. And the child might model this situation by continuing out with three blocks and then two more blocks and then counting all five together. So what if the question were, you have five blocks, and what if we put three on the shelf right now, and how many will you still have? The child might put up five fingers on the hand, will push out three in front of you and then count the remaining two. So using objects or directing differently with the same material what you are using, probably you already introduced subtraction, but that terminology has not been introduced till the age of first grade. So, and you need not do that also, but you may, you know, introduce or use multiple languages, because what I feel is that there are multiple ways to solve a single problem, and encourage your children to do that. Seventh one, encourage children to read for pleasure, my friends. So limit TV or other screen time for your kids. Trust me, it is these days for parents, it is getting really very difficult with online sessions of schools and the online sessions for after school activities also, whatever children are doing. So I would advise as a educator that please limit their activities, all right, to that extent that pick and choose, okay, pick and choose the activities what they love doing. Okay, don't emphasize on something which they are not ready to do it. So reading can help your child understand and express better, develop their logical thinking, and help them to focus on learning new things. You can frequently take them to visit the library, or probably you can, now there are so many online libraries. Like suppose if I know Scriff, okay, which is an online library which you can use for children these days, Sinotech, we have lots of books which we provide, you know, just like that. So this will give you an insight into your child's way of thinking. And again, I will emphasize on age appropriate reading, which is something very, very important. And then only that will definitely create or, you know, sustain their interest in doing something. Now, eighth one, encourage storytelling. Okay, so while you read the stories, naturally a child can role play, or you know, invite your child to make drawings to go with those stories. If the child is really good with it, make the main character, you know, suppose when I was little, I always loved characterization, okay, and I always loved to enact those characters which I loved in the form of dolls or whatever. So storytelling is something where, you know, I would definitely feel that up to certain age it is a very impactful idea. In my grade 2, 3 and 4, sometimes even in grade 5, we have storytelling as a medium of learning, where, you know, we call the best of storytellers of Ahmedabad and they are, you know, explaining a complex topic like environment also with a puppet show. So it's like, you know, because they have that skill, and if the storytelling is correctly done, the idea, the central idea of the theme, what you want to convey to the child, gets conveyed very quickly and easily while they enjoy. Okay, so, and I do it with lots of movies also. Give them some free time and space. That's the ninth one. So building skills is a methodical way. It is also important, but it is important to give kids enough space to freely explore their imagination, my friends. So, you know, let them dream and let them have full of the time. Where I would really like to, you know, give a proper example. If you have heard Mr. Soumya Joshi anytime, a playwriter and a director of the best of plays like 102 Not Out and Welcome Zindagi, you know, in all his interviews, he keeps telling that he was in school, he used to wander a lot and his parents never asked him, where are you going? But, you know, all those wanderings, you know, made him learn so much about human relationships, the behavior, human behavior. And now we know that he's the great storyteller. So that free time or free space, what child loved, he as a child loved, you know, made him become the great storyteller. So my dear friends, please give, you know, your children some free time, okay, to the idea what they love to do. Then the 10th one, please promote experiential learning. So provide them with ample of experiences. As I said, please take them everywhere in the neighborhoods, to the museum, if at all, Science City. We have the best of Science City in the city. Visit libraries, as I said, and normally to the gardens also, to sensitize them to the nature. Experiences, as I said, it could be in terms of either field trips or a movie or visiting a factory or playing games. And for teaching, say, as you know, as I said, that every time the idea should be said that, you know, a child should be able to gauge the whole idea that, okay, this is what I love doing, okay? And then, you know, suppose for experiential learning, you know, I would definitely tell you that suppose if I'm teaching fiber to fabric, then I not only, you know, first teach with audiovisual, then probably I take them, then I call with an expert who is the best in textile probably and knows quite a bit about the idea of having a fabric. So a fabric is made out of, the warp and the weft, what we are discussing. So probably then we go to on a field trip where they will be able to, you know, see khadi getting made and then come back to the classroom and the learning is absolutely incomplete without them doing it. So my dear friends, experiential learning, so giving an experience to everything is something very important. Maybe a field visit, as I said, meeting up with an expert, or probably, you know, the idea of giving them the overall experience about everything. Now in Sinotech, you know, how the next idea, you know, I would be able to give you the best example. The last one, categorize rewarding or maybe avoid rewarding children for being creative. My dear parents, now this is something which I don't know, you know, how to put up, but offerings or incentives or rewards to your kids to perform any creative activity can hinder the process sometimes. You know, you have to pick and choose. Now, suppose you imagine that I will, you know, the best idea, my parents-in-laws, both of them, you know, they are into psychology for years. So, you know, when I was discussing out with them, you know, the best example they could give was that a child is smart enough to understand, you know, that what kind of rewards you are giving, all right, what kind of rewards you are giving. And suppose for maybe for making a good drawing, you give a chocolate, and maybe for, you know, coming first, you give a chocolate. Imagine that for both the cases, the effort put in by a child is so very different. So then there will be no value of that chocolate at all. So what I'm trying to tell you is that, however, rewards them in terms of verbal appreciation most of the time, pat on the back or a hug or non-materialistic way. As famous psychologist Skinner said, that give them rewards, but it should be in proportion to the achievement. So my dear friends, to give you a simple simile, we have a huge carnival at your end called Sinofest every year, where the concept, where each child coming to us creates some innovative project or a model or science-based game or activity and showcases in front of pretty huge crowd, where they reward, their reward is not in terms of any prize for the best project. No, not at all. All 117 projects which were put up last year, naturally all of them had put up equal effort. So why that gift of first project and second project? Never ever. But in the form of appreciation, when they are presenting in front of more than 1200 people, probably that is the best reward they could feel, you know, later when you ask them that, my God, their confidence will go to the next level. So giving them that joy of science, creating something from scratch, my dear friends. So allow your children to master the creative activities that they are innately motivated to do, rather than motivating them with rewards and incentives for the same. So again, I think I'm very clear about what I said. And the last one, what I would like to say would be, invite your child to create all the time. Okay, whatever they are doing, forget about the mess they are making in the kitchen, or forget about the mess they are making while they are painting or something. But trust me, you must, encourage doing that. So I think with this, I have given my all 12 tips to all of you, you know, in such a way that probably I think you all might have understood, you know, better. So if any questions, you know, I'm absolutely open to questions. So I can read out many questions here. First is, how to develop scientific temperament in toddlers? How can I introduce science on daily basis in talking to her while doing something? All right. So my dear friends, my dear friend, whoever has asked this question, what I'm trying to tell you is that these 12 possibilities, it's a process, ma'am. So when you are trying to ask this particular question, it cannot be sudden, okay? See, whatever I said, that whenever you are giving lot of time, you give lot of time to the child. At the same time, probably give free time to the child to think. And the 12 ways, what I already said, you must follow in such a way that probably, you know, you can enhance that kind of scientific thinking. The next question is by Gayatri. My daughter doesn't show interest at the beginning, not excited to learn any new thing. Please help develop the interest. All right. So Gayatri, I would request you that probably, you know, sometimes it so happens that the child is also fed up of, you know, doing multiple activities. So restrict those activities. I would really request you. Okay. Pick and choose, okay? Give that free time. If you give that free space of half an hour also to the child, probably then in other time, if you are trying to give, you know, those kind of, what do you call, if you are trying to give that activity in that other time, okay, then probably she will be definitely open to that activity, all right? So give that free space, what I said, to the child. Yeah, the next question is by Pani Sharma. There are a lot of coding and artificial intelligence courses for 6 to 14 years. Should I go ahead with it? Is it age appropriate? Please guide. My son is 6 years old. So my dear Pani, what I would tell you would be that basically all these programs, coding and robotics and everything, for 6 to 14 years, I am a hardcore science person, okay? Not more about the technology part of it, But I have realized that technology is really good in some times like COVID. Right now, you know, I never thought that I would switch to technology for any kind of online sessions anytime or going virtual. But right now I am catering to the needs of so many children, you know, across the globe doing workshops and everything. So technology does wonders. But at the same time, what kind of robotic program you're looking at, that is also very important. If the coding and all, it is something which is before the age, if it is being introduced, I am not of that particular opinion. But at the same time, suppose, you know, if those coding programs are introduced correctly in terms of having a scientific thought process, okay, that scientific thought process, I'll give you a simple example that if just make your child, you know, close eyes and stand somewhere in the kitchen and then say that, okay, you want to reach to your bedroom now, okay, how many steps would you go to straight and then either take a left or right to reach your bedroom, all right? So basically, after closing the eyes, when the child is reactive to that particular thing, that is also a kind of coding, okay? But at the same time, what kind of coding classes you are exposing, that is also very, very important for a particular age. I would stress on that. So basically, I would definitely feel that suppose right now, you know, we have tied up with a company in Calcutta called Makersloft, and you know, I love the idea that not about coding and all, but suppose they are promoting every Saturday and Sunday, they are promoting free programs for children to make up something from Lego. Okay, now in that, the best part is that there are categories like some are storytellers, some are basic model builders. So it's like the competition is with a child and parent together. Okay, so it's like when the child is spending that much time with parent, I love that idea. Okay, it can be for some other activity also, not necessarily Lego building, but still, you know, that idea itself is beautiful where when that parent is spending time with the child. That's number one. Number two, children who may not make a good model, but probably they are imaginators, okay? They are good storytellers. I have a child like that who tells a fantastic story, some verbal story which actually appeals us so much that, you know, that child may become a good leader later, okay? So that's what. So we do not know at this very point of time what can we do as a parent, but as I said, restrict, expose them everywhere, at least once or twice, but that way that is enough for you to understand whether the child is actually interested or not. Then the next question probably is by Tapas. My little one is 2 year old, really difficult to engage her with certain thing. She always loves to mess up the things, though she keeps learning the new things from books, but for very short period. Yeah, so Mr. Tapas, I think you know, that's the problem right now. See, it's not about right now. If I talk to you, my son is 17, and when he was little, so before 15 years, he was also very hyperactive, my friend. So basically what happens is that the channelizing the whole idea, see, the teacher in Riverside helped me to do that at that point of time, that channelize the energies, all right? So channelize the energies in something which is constructive enough, not destructive enough. So when you say that making up of a mess, what kind of mess you're talking about, I don't know. But sometimes making up of that mess, ask her correct kind of question that, okay, suppose in a paint, if you have mixed up a salt and now if we paint, what is the difference what we are getting? Okay, is the painting appearing different? If I mix up the oil with it, is the painting appearing different? So let her make the mess. But what kind of mess, what kind of question, if you can afford to, you know, clearing up all those mess, you can, you know, definitely do that. But please try channelizing, you know, her. Keep, be patient as a parent. As it is, you know, as parents, once we become parents, we understand that how difficult parenting job is, you know, how our parents might have done it with us long ago and so beautifully. Anyway, so the next question is from Jayu Sang. I am anxious to know how to develop learning attitude and aptitude in kids from toddlers to teens. So my dear friend, I think whatever I said, you know, you can, this will be there on Facebook. So I think you can, you know, note down those 12 points in the examples what I gave. Trust me, if you try practicing those 12 points, gradually it definitely helps. I can definitely guarantee you that. Okay, and exposing them to correct kind of probably the school, you know, matters a lot. School plays a very crucial role, and so does the after school activities. See, it's something like you try and imagine and think about your own self, that what, how many activities were you doing when you were little? Okay, we might be doing dancing and we might be doing this, but how many are we pursuing right now? Okay, maybe because it was not in our priority, maybe we do not have time. There are multiple reasons. So is the same thing for our children also, that whatever activities we are exposing them to, probably, you know, they are not interested in all of them. Probably they might not pursue all those, you know, but at the same time, they may pick up something what they love doing. And the common problem these days, what my Sinotech parents are asking me, that children are on gadgets and they love playing games. So I think I always tell them that what if, you know, when I am talking to children, that what if, beta, instead of playing these games and just, you know, investing, not wasting, investing your time, you know, and time just flies away. It is not there for you to do any kind of creative thinking if you're just playing games. But what if, you know, you grow up to that limit that you make those games on your own? Right, and for which probably I would love to give one more example. One of my husband's friend's wife, you know, she being a housewife, imagine she was she was very much interested in mythology and mythological stories, and you know, with somebody's help, probably she came up with the idea of having the online games on mythological stories. So imagine, this is the best example I think we could give it to children, that what if we are self capable of doing that ourselves rather than, you know, just keep playing and wasting time. So probably next question is by Shrini. Hello doctor, meri beti ko A B C D aati hai, lekin wo writing karna pasand nahi karti. Poem aati hai, mujhe kya karna hoga? All right. Kitna beautiful question aapne pucha hai. Sach bataun, writing, aap socho. India mein, matlab hum aisa sochte hain ki writing, matlab बचपन से, मतलब इतना जल्दी, आप सोचो कि हमें कब स्कूल में रखा था. हाँ, हम 4 साल के पहले या 5 साल के पहले स्कूल में नहीं गए हैं, है ना. बट अभी तो 2.5 साल या 3 साल नहीं हुए और स्कूल में छोड़ दिया. हाँ, तो आप सोचो कि लिखना आना ही चाहिए ये एज तक. आई डोंट बिलीव इन दैट. डोंट वरी, इट्स अ ग्रेजुअल प्रोसेस एंड सब सीखना है, सीख जाएगी, अपना टाइम आएगा. ओके, सो अपना टाइम आएगा, एज वी से. ओके, सो उसका भी टाइम आएगा. एंड आप बिल्कुल फिक्र मत करो, एंड कभी उसको किसी और के साथ कंपेयर मत करो. एवरी चाइल्ड इज वेरी डिफरेंट. माई डियर फ्रेंड, वी हैव स्टार्टेड द होल न्यू सिस्टम वट वी आर ट्राइंग टू यू नो सी राइट नाउ. कि इतना जल्दी स्कूल में छोड़ दिया, और जल्दी स्कूल में, मतलब डिपेंडिंग अपॉन द काइंड ऑफ स्कूल व्हाट दे आर गोइंग टू, यू नो, स्कूल में लिखना सिखा दिया, वो विगर दिया, रिगर दिया, दैट्स नॉट रिक्वायर्ड. सो बेसिकली, यू नो, दैट वाज द होल पॉइंट. यू नो, फॉर सम टाइम वी वर बेस्ड इन US एंड इन मॉन्टेसरी ऑल्सो. इन US, माई सन, यू नो, we used to always think that how beautiful this methodology could be, you know, and the whole idea of coming back to India was also again the same, that here also he was going to that beautiful school where there was no insistence on specific writing ki itna to karna hi padega, ye to karna hi padega. To aap ekdam nischint ho jao, wo apne time pe sab kuch karegi. All right, and then okay, Mehra Sakshi, how do I develop more fun for my 3-year-old understand science, what basic concepts I begin from? So Sakshi ji, main kahungi ki probably for a 3-year-old, aap socho, sab kuch dikhao ghar pe, matlab ki aaj, matlab suppose kitchen chemistry try kar rahe ho, karo. Okay, but aisa nahi hai ki suppose ek glass liya, usme haldi dala, thoda sa yellow ho gaya, fir usme thoda sa नींबू के फूल डाले, कुछ नहीं होगा. ओके, टेस्ट विल बी डिफरेंट, बट कुछ नहीं होगा. सपोज उसमें अगर थोड़ा सा बेकिंग सोडा डाला और अब नींबू का फूल डाला, तो इट विल स्टार्ट पॉपिंग अप. ओके, बिकॉज बोथ ऑफ देम आर रिएक्टिंग, यू नो. बट यू नो, एज अ 3-year-old, डू नॉट एक्सपेक्ट योर चाइल्ड टू आस्क यू कि ये क्यों हो रहा है, कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड बन रहा है एंड वो पॉप अप हो रहा है, सॉरी, लेट हिम एंजॉय द होल प्रोसेस. ओके, कि बबल्स बबल्स बबल्स, व्हाट आर वी सेइंग, यस द बबल्स आर कमिंग आउट. ओनली थिंग व्हाट ही शुड बी एबल टू, ही और शी शुड बी एबल टू अंडरस्टैंड, अ 3 ईयर ओल्ड, कि जब पहले सिट्रिक एसिड डाला या नींबू के फूल डाले तो पॉपिंग नहीं हुआ, पर बेकिंग सोडा डालने के बाद अगर नींबू के फूल डाले तो पॉपिंग हुआ. अगर इतना डिफरेंस समझ में आ गया, बहुत हो गया. कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड बन रहा है वो नहीं समझ में आया तो भी कुछ जरूरत ही नहीं है, इंट्रोड्यूस मत करो, प्लीज डू नॉट ओवर एक्सपोज देम, दैट्स व्हाट आई सेड. ओके, सो आई थिंक या द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज बाय नाम्बुरी 05. 26 months old girl doesn't like sit and play with toys. How can I make her engage with learning toys? Do not worry, madam. You can try out probably kitchen utensils, probably different sizes and shapes. See, learning toys, as you said, that she's not getting hung to, like jigsaw or something. Do not worry. Okay. But what you can do is probably you can make a, you know, in front of her, you can make a jigsaw. Okay. Suppose what I used to do was that, suppose from the number 5, I used to make Ganpati for my Ganpati, the figure of Ganpati for my son, and then exactly cut it into half. Okay. And that would definitely show symmetry. And then, you know, I will try showing him that, okay, now try joining to make the whole Ganpati. So see, if she's not sitting with the ready jigsaw puzzle, probably you can make a puzzle for her. Okay. Engage her in that, doing that, and then try showing that, okay, there is a symmetry, and that's how, and then slowly you can introduce jigsaw puzzle. So this is just, I think, one way of, you know, trying it out. You have to be very, very patient, ma'am, as a parent. The next question is by Reinfo. My 2 year angel have sharp mind and very active. Due to multilingual environment, her words are mix and match. Please guide me, how can I make advantage of this situation? See, it is something lovely. It has been said also that a child can learn many languages until the age of 5. Probably, matlab aisa kehte hain ki 5 saal tak bachcha bahut kuch seekh sakta hai. Okay, to ye to bahut achhi baat hai ki usko multi language se, matlab ki mummy kuch aur bol rahi hai, papa alag language bol rahe hain, dada dadi kuch alag language bol rahe hain, English hai, Gujarati hai, Hindi hai, jo bhi language mein baat kar rahe hain. See, but always make a habit that even if she is mixing it right now, everything is getting registered in her mind. Alright? See, if you are speaking in Gujarati at a time, Gujarati bolta ho, to Gujarati shuddh bolo. Okay? Tame pote shuddh bolo. Hindi agar bol rahe hain, to Hindi bhi bahut achhi boliye, shuddh boliye. Okay? Mix mat kijiye English ke saath. Or if you are speaking in English, probably speak English properly. And if at all you are speaking in Marathi, naturally your own language, suppose, then you can speak accordingly. So you can, if at all you are speaking in Marathi, kashi ahes, tar, see, basically for my son, if I give you my very own example, trust me, up to the age of 3 years, me and my husband, both of us, you know, we definitely speak English, but you know, we made it sure that we were all the time speaking in Gujarati, because we knew that once my son will go to the school, especially when he will go to the school in US, naturally he's not going to hear any other language other than English, right? So that he's, as it is going to pick up, so why not continue with Gujarati, which is like, you know, which he's not going to hear in that school. All right. So we, you know, so right now we really feel very privileged that when he is able to read also Gujarati, when it is not there in his school. But, you know, because I introduced that to him till the age of 6, he is able to do it. So I think, my dear parent, please stick to your mother tongue. Okay. While speaking to your child, whatever is the language, come what may. And whatever you are speaking, speak clearly. Because never think ki hum nahi bolege to bachcha English nahi bolega. Wo definitely help karta hai. Otherwise, aap bade age mein agar bachcha 6 years ke upar hai, to aap aisa kar sakte ho ki pure din mein ek ghanta aisa rakho ki jo English mein baat kar rahe ho, wo ek ghante mein. To shayad that will, your language will definitely help your child also. But otherwise, if you keep speaking in English in your, at your home also, probably, you know, the child will not speak your own language at all. Okay, the next question is from Rifat. माई डॉटर इज 5 ईयर्स ओल्ड एंड 11 मंथ्स की है, शोइंग दिस इंटरेस्ट इन स्टडीज,
नो इंटरेस्ट इन स्टडीज,
शोइंग नो इंटरेस्ट इन स्टडीज. ओके, नो वरीज मैडम, प्रोबेबली हर इंटरेस्ट वुड बी समथिंग डिफरेंट इन टर्म्स ऑफ म्यूजिक और डांस और समथिंग एल्स, वो किसी और चीज के लिए बनी होगी, एज आई सेड. सो प्लीज एक्सपोज, नाउ अवर एक्सपेरिमेंट इज रेडी. ऑल राइट, एंड माई डियर पेरेंट्स, आई वुड लाइक टू शो यू समथिंग. ऑल राइट, नाउ लुक एट दिस. ऑल राइट, इफ आई जस्ट गो वेरी वेरी क्लोज, यू विल नोटिस दैट आई हैड यूज टू पेन्स, इफ यू करेक्टली रिमेंबर. ऑल राइट, आई हैड यूज टू पेन्स, एंड वन वॉज द वाइट बोर्ड मार्कर, एंड यू कैन सी दैट द वाइट बोर्ड मार्कर डॉट बींग द यू नो अ सॉर्ट ऑफ अ परमानेंट इंक, द काइंड ऑफ इनग्रेडियंट और केमिकल विच इज देयर इन साइड, इट डिड नॉट स्प्रेड एट ऑल. Whereas my black color sketch pen, what I had used, okay, showed multiple colors, because black is mixture of all the colors. You can try it out with all the different colors with your children at home, okay, to show the primary and secondary colors to toddlers probably, and you can, you know, if this I can explain it in very well in Gujarati, that when I was little, we were always told that lal pedo ne vadali mul rang kehvay, baki na beja bada melavni thi thai, meaning red yellow, okay, as and vadali meaning blue, so they are the primary colors. So if they are put up over a sketch pen like this, they will never spread into colors, because they are the formation of a single color. Whereas any other color you pick up, say green color, it will definitely give two bands, blue and yellow. All right, so my dear friends, I think I'm very very clear about the idea of this particular experiment I wanted to show you. So before forgetting, I think I should, you know, take it up in between the questions. All right, and my dear friends, the next question is from Mr. Hasit. My son is 2.5 year old and he's diagnosed with autism. He still cannot spell small words. Please advise me, how should I make him understand the language we speak and make him to speak and interact? Probably, I'm not a specialized person, Mr. Hasit, but I would definitely say that today also, if I see Tare Zameen Par, all right, that I definitely feel very, very touched. Imagine that in the city, the boy who is definitely declared, you know, to be eccentric and not normal, you know, turned out to be absolutely normal, you know, if treated well by a particular person. So I think for you, I would definitely say that please search for a correct kind of mentor, correct kind of a person who can, you know, help you out. Probably we have children coming in Sinotech, you know, who at the even age of 9 and 10 years, who are little bit, you know, not normal or little bit off, you know, then the growth wise, I'm telling. So, but that's perfectly okay as far as they are enjoying the activities, as far as they are able to understand what I'm speaking, it is absolutely okay. If I can be of any help to you, you can let me know, my dear friend. So, we can definitely talk. And as you can see, we also have a Facebook page of Sinotech with the same name, Instagram page also. You can definitely write to us and we can surely help you out. Then we have the next question from Miss Ritu Malhotra. Hi ma'am, how can I improve concentration in my 7-year-old son? He is very slow writer and always try to escape from written work. So again, my answer would be same. Please channelize the energies in the correct direction, ma'am. Please channelize the energies. Try making him do, utilize his energy, you know, in a certain way, so that, you know, he is able to focus. Always have that one-on-one dialogue with your son. Trust me, I do it with lot of my Sinotech children one-on-one, and trust me, definitely just one time talk helps so much, you know, because they are equally good like other children, but probably if they are not able to focus, that, you know, would not reap the correct kind of results sometimes we parents look for. So and also probably, you know, in their life also it will matter a lot. As I channelize my son's energy in playing piano, probably, you know, you can search for something similar. All right. Then the next question I would say is from Gitanjali Chinderkar Lele. Can you suggest age appropriate toys for 1 to 1.5 year old to improve their skills? Ma'am, for that, I think, you know, there are so many things, you know, when you go to a toy store, see, always pick up a box or whatever. And always try to read, okay, next to the brand, it will be always written, okay, the age group which is relevant, okay, for 3 to 5 years, for 7 to 9 years, or for 9 to 12 years, like that, okay. So for your age group, see, always look for that. So it's a general question I'm taking up. So not related to 1 to 1.5 years, but probably, you know, whenever you go and shop a toy, trust me, at least even if you are shopping it from a smaller places, once at least you can visit those bigger toy stores where, you know, they have ample of varieties coming from Europe and US and all. Maybe sometimes, you know, all those good toys, but all the toys and good brand names specifically will be, you know, we put up the age group which is relevant, okay? So please read out those and you can identify that particular age group, come back to your shop from where you're shopping, and you know, accordingly you can shop. All right, the next question is, how to develop scientific temperament in toddlers? How can I introduce science on daily basis? So this I already took up, I think. And yeah, I think I have, please suggest some STEM activities for toddlers. All right. So, my dear friend, now the idea of STEM, okay, that question is, I think, by Tripti Kothari. All right. Tripti, I would say that instead of STEM, it is STEAM now, okay. So, it is the art, what I'm telling you. See, this is something, the best example I could show you at this very point of time. Where probably, you know, by doing the drawing kind of activity also, say, if I tell you that in that Ganpati example, what I give you, basically, you can say that you divide it into parts and you can show symmetry, maths. Okay, similar to that, suppose if you're doing this, you are actually trying to show the primary and the secondary colors. And with that, probably, you know, you would be not only introducing the science that why only the permanent marker did not show any color, and why, because a normal sketch pen, the black color was a mixture of so many different colors, okay, it just showed up. See, if I would have kept it for a longer period of time, it would have shown some 7 bands of different colors showing the mixture of that black color, okay, forming the black color. So my dear friend, I think please follow these 12 tips what I showed today, all right? And trust me, we also do lots of such free programs for parents, and I'm really thankful to First Cry, Intellimedium, you know, for giving me this beautiful platform today to talk to you all. And with so many comments, I think I'm so happy that parents are listening to me right from the beginning. Trust me, my dear parents, this interview would remain here. Follow these 12 tips and slowly, it's a gradual process, okay? Nothing happens suddenly for any activity. Parents must give at least 18 months, you know, to, you know, persuade a kind of activity properly, whether the child is interested or not. From the day one, if the child is telling you, no, I don't want to do it, I don't want to go online, I don't want to do this, that means the child is really not interested. Sometimes you can actually, you know, just guide them or handhold them and then say that, no, this is very good, better just try it out, all right? Let us try for 1 or 2 times. But if still it is the same thing happening, then, you know, there is the time for introspection for us also. You can definitely call us, okay? And like our Facebook page, you know, for our Instagram page for with the same name, Sinotech, Sci for science, No for knowledge, and tech for technology, my friends. So we also have the graded program and online program too, from grade 2 to grade 10. Get back to us. And that program is for both, you know, as we all always say, think science, think Sinotech. And if you think math, please visualize Sinomath. So thank you so much.